And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Baqarah, as well as in Surah Al-Ra'd, and in many other places, that He gives everybody an opportunity. He gives them an opportunity for guidance. Nobody will die until and unless they have had opportunities to turn to the right path. Then on the day of Qiyamah, it will be held for them or against them, depending on whether they heard or did not, depending on whether they took heed or not. Look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. He says from the very beginning in Surah Al-Baqarah,
فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدَى فَمَنْ تَبِعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ
We will send everyone guidance. Whenever guidance comes to any of you, then those who follow it, there will be no reason for them to fear nor to worry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they will have the goodness in the dunya as well as in the akhirah. And this is why in Surah Al-Ra'd, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
إنما أنت منذر ولكل قوم هاد
Allah says, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are a warner. And we'd like you all to know that for every community, for every people, we have sent a guide. Every community, there's a guide who comes to them or who lives in their midst. And every nation, Allah sends a guide to them or a guide lives in their midst. It's up to us to find the guide, to follow the guide, to listen to the guidance. Then, because the ulama, because the scholars of this religion are not prophets, they are not flawless, they are not perfect. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, gives us guidance and tells us,
فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ
Give good news to those whom when they listen to a speech, they follow the best of it. Because human beings can err. I am standing in front of you. I might utter a word or two that might not be of the respect that the crowd is deserving or is deserving of. Or I might make an error. I might misquote very slightly a verse. And I expect people to stand up and get up and immediately correct me. Subhanallah. If that does happen, it is your duty. When the words of Allah are misquoted, it is the right of every Muslim to correct such a person, no matter what type of knowledge they have, because they are human beings. And this is the reason why in Salatul Taraweeh, though it is our duty to learn the verses as best as we can, when there is a mistake, it is the right of every person in the congregation to scream out what is correct if they are 100% sure that they know what is happening. Subhanallah. This Quran is not a book that is just for some and not for others. And it definitely has guidance in it. So therefore, when we are quoting it, we should quote it without an error. Whereas when it comes to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we should quote it as close as possible, as close as we can. If we make a small mistake, for as long as the meaning is correct, inshallah, we will be forgiven. But when it comes to the Quran, there is no scope of making errors there. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. And may He guide us to the right path. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, regarding those whom, when they listen to some speech, they follow the best of it. Imam Malik ibn Anas, Imam Dar al-Hijrah, who was sitting in Al-Madinatul Munawwara in front of the grave of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he pointed at the grave and he said,
مَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ إِلَّا وَيُؤْخَذُ مِنْ كَلَامِهِ وَيُرَدُّ إِلَّا صَاحِبَ هَذَا الْقَبْرِ
He says, every single person, you need to take some of what they say and throw back some of what they say. Besides the one who is resting in this grave, you need to take absolutely everything he has said. Subhanallah. That means myself and yourselves, we cannot just listen to every statement that is being uttered without verifying it, without making sure that this is correct. If we are to follow absolutely everything of a certain man, for example, who's not a prophet, but a human like us, like myself and yourselves, we would be following his mistakes as well. You know, normally when people are reciting the Quran, sometimes, and obviously it's good because we are asked to read in an Arabic tone and to read in an Arabic accent. That is the hadith. The Prophet ﷺ says, read the Quran in an Arabic accent. How would you like it if I were to speak English in a non-English accent? In a typical Indian accent, so to speak. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. When you speak a language, speak it exactly as it is meant to be spoken. If you were to speak Zulu, try to speak like those whose language it is. So when you read the Quran, try to read in the accent of the Arabs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. The most eloquent of people was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This Quran guides us to that which is good. We are meant to be reading it in the perfect way. And I normally say that when you have a person who does not read the news, for example, in the correct accent, and they put an accent on that absolutely confuses the people, what would happen? They would be fired in a short time, or nobody would want to listen to that news because they wouldn't even understand what is happening. The same applies when it comes to the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is full of guidance. It is important that we read it in a perfect way. We try our best to read it in a manner that will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was a point I was going to make, but sadly it has slipped my mind. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it comes back, inshallah. Allahumma salli ala nabina Muhammad wa ala ali nabina Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. Let's continue with this topic. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He has sent all the messengers with guidance.
هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون.
We read that verse in tonight's verses as well. And it is repeated in the Quran in a few places. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it is He who sends the messengers with the deen, with the guidance. It is Allah who sends the messengers with guidance. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who can follow this guidance. Over and above that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that guidance is a gift from Allah. Guidance is a gift from Allah. We should treat it as a gift. When you have a gift, the first thing you do is you are thankful for it. So thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the gift of guidance. And this is why the people of Jannah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quotes them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي هَدَانَا لِهَذَا وَمَا كُنَّا لِنَهْتَدِيَ لَوْلَا أَنْ هَدَانَا اللَّهِ.
When they will be sitting in Jannah, they will say, Oh Allah, we thank You, we praise You every single way. All praise is due to You for having guided us to this. Had it not been for Your guidance, we would never have been rightly guided. So we need to thank Allah. I'm sure you hear the words, Alhamdulillahi alladhi hadana lihada, many times. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be praised in every single way. We praise Him for having guided us to this deen. Wallahi, there are others who don't even have a little bit of deen in them. And yet we are sitting here in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we are not thankful, we might be from amongst those who are rejected. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never ever do that to us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how important it is to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to consider it a gift, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
بَلِ اللَّهُ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ.
You want to know what is the big gift? The big gift is when Allah has guided you. Allah is the one who gives you the big gift when He has guided you to iman. This is why we say, we declare, we confirm, we confess that the biggest gift we have is iman, the belief in Allah, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That statement is by far the biggest gift that we have all been given. And that is the statement that will take us into Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all paradise. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
قُلْ إِنَّنِي هَدَانِي رَبِّي إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ.
Another method of thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to declare that Allah has guided me to the right path. I praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of in Surah Al-An'am. And then Allah tells us whom He guides. Who does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide? The first point we need to remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ankabut,
وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينا لَنَهْدِيَنَّ لَنَهُمْ سُبُلَنَا.
Those who try hard, those who struggle to come towards us, we will open the doors of guidance for them. So guidance cannot just come when we sit and we make a dua, Ya Allah, guide us. And then we are going to the nightclubs, we're going to the casinos, we're going everywhere, we want to drink the bottles and what have you of alcohol. May Allah protect us. Then we make dua and we tell others, make dua that Allah guides me. And Allah guide me, Allah guide me. But you got a bottle in your hand, guidance won't come like that. Allah says, when you try, when you make an effort, I will definitely open the doors for you. So this is the role we play. We play the part, the effort. Make the effort, be genuine. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. That was in Surah Al-Ankabut. In Surah Al-Ra'd, Allah says, وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ أَنَابَ. Allah guides towards him those who turn towards him. Those who repent, those who have iman, Allah guides them. Those who give with their wealth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides them. Those who soften up their hearts, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides them. Those who do good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides them. Those who believe in the life after death, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides them. All these angles are made mention of in the Quran. Those who are thankful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides them. Listen to what he says in Surah An-Nahl about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. Allah says,
شَاكِرًا لِأَنْعُمِهِ اِجْتَبَاهُ وَهَدَاهُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ.
Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam was very thankful for the gifts Allah had bestowed upon him. So Allah says, so we chose him and we guided him to the straight path. So when we are thankful to Allah, we show gratitude. And what is the means of showing gratitude? Not only to say, I thank you, O Allah, but live your life according to Allah's command. He's given you so much. Subhanallah. If you live your life according to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, automatically that is thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about those who accept destiny when it comes in their way. They will also be rightly guided. There are certain verses in the Quran where Allah says, those are the people who are definitely guided. And one of these verses Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah,
وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ.
Those whom when calamity overtakes them, when they have a difficulty in their lives, they make a dua saying, O Allah, we belong to you and we are all going to return to you. They are patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they are the ones who are definitely rightly guided. So we need to be content at all times. When something negative comes in our direction, we should take the opportunity to convert it into something positive. You've made an accident. May Allah protect us all. It's time to be patient, which is an act of worship that you won't be able to engage in unless something negative comes in your direction. When something negative comes in your direction that you feel as a human being is negative, say you've broken an arm. We ask Allah to grant us all, inshallah, good arms. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never to break our bones for us. But at the same time, if a bone is broken, that is an opportunity to gain closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the positive of it. Don't only look at the negative of it. And thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He has given. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the best, inshallah.